Welcome IP students. This is the second video of Numpy in which we'll be learning how to do practicals. This is the second part. In the first part, you must have seen and observed how we can create 1D and 2D array and how to print elements of those arrays. Now in this second part, firstly let us start with this program. I have already written this program in which we will learn the slicing and joining. Slicing and joining in the 1D and 2D array with respect to NumPy. And then in the second program, we'll be learning how to do various types of calculations with the arrays. And thirdly, we will learn how to find variance, covariance, and correlation between the multiple data sets, right? So in this first program, as you can see, firstly the first statement is import numpy as n. Okay, so this module needs to be imported. Okay, and n is the alternate name or alias name of numpy. So in place of numpy we'll be using n. Now here you can see we have created an array, n dot array, using this array function. Okay, and in this array we have these elements 2, 4, 6, 8. Okay, and it is all stored in variable a. Now let us use slicing. Now print a 1, 3. 1 means the starting point, and 3 is the last point means 3 minus 1 means 2 index wise. So here it will start with index 1 and ends, or it will go till index 2. So starting from 1 to 2. Okay, here this is index 0, index 1, index 2 and index 3. Since there are 4 elements, so these elements, the index of these elements will be starting with 0. So 0, 1, 2, 3, right? So you can see we have to print from index 1 till 2. 1 means 4 and 6. You can see the output 4, 6. The first output is 4, 6. Okay, secondly print 1 index 1 till the last element, colon, and there is no value, means starting from index 1 till the last element. Index 1 is 4, so 4, 6, 8, all the elements after 4. So 4, 6, 8, you can see. Then print A minus 2 till the end. Now minus 2 is, if you see the minus index, it starts from the last. This is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, and minus 4. Okay, so 8 is at minus 1, 6 minus 2. Okay, now it is starting with minus 2, so it will start with minus 6. Okay, so minus 6, 6, index minus 2 means 6. Okay, so 6 and 8, okay, means starting with this index, okay, till the last means till 8. So 6 and 8 will be printed. You can see here 6 and 8. Okay, likewise print A, there is just colon means all the elements. If you don't put any element before and after the colon, it means all the elements. You can see all the elements have been printed, 2, 4, 6, 8. Okay, next I have created a two-dimensional array. But you can see there are two lists. Okay, list 1 and list 2. In list 1 there are elements 1, 2, 3, 4, and in list 2 there are elements 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, now firstly I have printed B, all the elements. You can see all the elements 2, 4, 6, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4. No, sorry. Okay, let me scroll it down. Yes, from here. Okay, and let me scroll it down this also. Now this is visible. Okay, now starting with two-dimensional array. So two-dimensional array is in B, okay, where we have two list. Okay, similarly you can have multiple list, 2, 3, 4, 5, okay, as the requirement. Now print B, so all the elements in the matrix form will be printed. Okay, so this is the first row and this is the second row. Okay, so row wise it will print firstly 1, 2, 3, 4, then second row 5, 6, 7, and you can see 1, 2, 3, 4, second row 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so this is print B. Now print B, now we have used slicing in 2D array. Okay, look very carefully. In 2D array there are two indexes, okay, separated by comma. First is starting with 0 till 1, means 0 and 1. 0 and 1 means the first argument stands for row. So 0 and 1 means both the rows, row 0 and row 1. So this is row 0 and this is row 1. Okay, so in both the rows, now second argument stands for the columns. How many columns? 0 to 2 columns. Okay, means 0, 1 and 2. Means in both the rows, first three elements, 1, 2, 3 and 5, 6, 7, you can see. 1, 2, 3 and 5, 6, 7. Right? Now secondly, B 0, 0 means first row only, comma, colon, colon means all the columns. Okay, so first row, all the columns. First row is this, all the columns means 1, 2, 3, 4, you can see 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, then let me scroll it down a little and this also. Now you can see this one, print B. Now see very carefully, in the first argument double colon minus 1. Double colon minus 1 means the elements will be displayed in the reverse order. Similarly, double colon minus 1, elements will be displayed in the reverse order. Okay, you can see here. Okay, this is the second row and in the reverse manner it has shown all the data elements, 8, 7, 6, 5, then 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, so it means in the reverse order. Now let's come to the joining, how to join two arrays, be it one dimensional array or two dimensional array. Okay, now first, now arrays can be joined using a function called concatenate. Okay, so this function is the part of NumPy. Now we are concatenating or combining the elements of A and A. You can write it like this, N dot concatenate A comma A, means elements of A, okay, will be combined and will be displayed, only A. Okay, what were the elements in A? I think 2, 4, 6, 8, you can see. 2, 4, 6, 8, again 2, 4, 6, 8, two times, because we have concatenated A comma A. Now, here, now we are concatenating B, N dot concatenate B comma B. Since B is 2D array, so it will be concatenated like this. You can see first B, 1, 2, 3, 4, second 5, 6, 7, 8. Now one more B, because there are two B's, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so in this way, two 2D arrays can be concatenated like this. Okay, you can see very carefully here in this function concatenate, there is firstly a parenthesis, then in this square bracket we have passed the two arrays B comma B, then again square bracket close. Okay, so this is very important, otherwise it might throw an error. Now again, we have concatenated this, be with the other two dimensional array, okay, which we have passed directly, 9 1 11 12 and 21 22 23 and 24. This is the 2D array, okay, which we have concatenated directly. Okay, you can see the result here. Can see the result. Firstly, B 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, then 9, 1, 11, 12, and then 21, 22, 23, and 24. Okay, so this is how we can concatenate two 2D array. Now, student, this is very important. V stack and H stack. Now, in V stack means two arrays, means B, they have been concatenated vertically, right? Means firstly the elements of B will be displayed, then in the same column the elements of second B will also be displayed, right? You can see 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, this is B. Now again 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, so this is the V stack vertical. In horizontal, you can see, means firstly the element of B, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now second B will be displayed in the second row, not in the same column. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so this is the vertical stack. So in this way, we can combine two array elements either vertically or horizontally using V stack and H stack. Okay, so it was all about joining and slicing. Understood? Now let's move on to the second program, where we'll be learning how to make all kinds of calculations on the array. We'll switch to num3. This is num3, and let us run it. Firstly, run num3, and you can see the result. Okay, now I'll be explaining each and every step. Now, first, okay, in this program, I have created two 1D array, A and B. In A there are elements 2, 4, 6, 8, and in B there are elements 1, 3, 5, 7. I have taken all the 4 even numbers in A and all the 4 odd numbers in B. Now simple calculation, print A plus B. Now 2 plus 1, 4 plus 3, 6 plus 5, 8 plus 7. Okay, so plus will be calculated, okay, like this. Similarly, A minus B, 2 minus 1, 4 minus 3, 6 minus 5, and 8 minus 7. You can see in the result. Okay, so this is print A plus B. You can see 3, 2 plus 1, 7, 4 plus 3, 11, 6 plus 5, 15, 8 plus 7. Similarly, minus 2 minus 1, 1, 4 minus 3, 1, 6 minus 5, 1, 8 minus 7, 1. Like this. Similarly, multiplication. 2 into 1, 2, 4 into 3, 12, like this. Okay. Similarly, division, 2 upon 1, 2, 4 upon 3, 1.333, 6 upon 5, 1.2, 8 upon 7, 1.1428, and so on. Okay, so calculation is very simple. Okay, with this 1D array. Now let's move further. Now this is two dimensional array C. Okay, you can see in C there are two list items. Okay, now we are making calculation. Print C plus A. Now you can see very carefully. I am adding the value of A to C. What will happen? Because in C there are two rows. So in both the rows, the element of A will be added. Okay, you can see. In A, what are the elements? 2, 4, 6, 8. You can see 6 plus 2, 8, 5 plus 4, 9, 4 plus 6, 10, and 3 plus 8, 11. Okay, similarly, 1 plus 2, 3. Okay, 4 plus 4, 8, like this. Okay, means in all these elements, the elements of A will be added to all these elements. Similarly, to all these elements, element of A will be subtracted in this. Okay, so this is C minus A. Okay, now further we have used some predefined aggregate functions. You can see, okay, now I have used these aggregate functions with A. Very simple, print A dot sum means it will sum up all the elements of A, which is 20, means 4, 2 plus 4 plus 6 plus 8, 20. Similarly, maximum in A, which is 8, minimum in A, which is 2, mean value of all the elements of A, which is 5.0, and median value of all the elements of A, which is 5.0. In this way, you can use all these predefined functions, sum, max, mean and median. Okay, mean and median are the statistical functions. Okay, now in the next program we will see how to find the variance, covariance and third is I think correlation. Yes, these three. Now you can see this program. Here you can see there are two array, A and B. In A there are 7 values, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, and in array B there are again 7 values, okay, which are all odd. Now we can find out and print variance, okay, of a particular data set. Okay, students, you must be wondering what is variance, what is covariance and what is correlation. Okay, now let me tell you in short what is variance. You must have heard the mean value or the median value. Mean value is just like the middle value of a set of numeric data. This is mean value. Now from this mean value, all the other data elements will differ with some value. Okay, so this is called the variability of all the data items. So if we add all the variabilities of data items and divide the sum of them with the number of elements, then we get the variance of that data set. Okay, so variance can be found out in NumPy very easily by invoking function var. Okay, so var stands for variance. So this is variance. Variance means variability of all the data element from its mean value. Okay, suppose mean value is 15, suppose 15, and the data item is 8. So what is the difference? 7 is the difference. Okay, similarly, all the data elements will differ with some value from its mean value. Okay, so sum of all the variabilities divided by the total number of data elements, okay, is what is known as variance. So variance can be found out using a function var. Similarly, covariance. Now what is covariance? Covariance is the measure of relationship of two data sets. Okay, means two data sets, how are they related with each other in terms of variance, or you can say how the variance of two data sets are related with each other. Okay, so it is a measure of relationship between the variance of two data sets. That is why in this function covariance, COV, cov, we have passed two data set A comma B. Okay, okay, and in the square bracket 0 comma 1. Okay, I'll tell you later on why I have used 0 comma 1. Okay, so in this way we can find out covariance of two data sets. So covariance is always between the two data sets, and variance is always of a particular data set one. Okay, so here we have found the variance with respect to one data set and covariance with respect to two data sets, which are A and B. Now this is the correlation coefficient. What is correlation? Correlation is also the measure of the relationship of the variance of two data sets. It is a little different from covariance, but their concept is almost the same. Okay, so in this way we can find variance, covariance and correlation coefficient. Okay, we just need to invoke the function var, cov and cor coef. Okay, you can see in the output. Okay, let me run it firstly. Now you can see the result. First, variance of A, this data set. Okay, the variance is 16. Okay, similarly covariance of these two data sets, which is 18.66. okay, students, one thing to be understood which is very important: if covariance comes out to be positive, it means there is a positive relationship between A and B. What does it mean? It means if the value of A increases, then the value of B will also increase. If the value of A decreases, then value of B will also decrease, right? But if covariance is negative, then the relationship of A and B are inversely proportional with each other. Means if value of A increases, the value of B will decrease, and vice versa. Okay, so this is the significance of positive or negative covariance. Now thirdly, we have found correlation coefficients of A and B. You can see 1 1, this is a matrix of the covariance coefficient, which is 1 1 1 1. One thing about correlation: if correlation comes out to be and is very close to 1, either 1 or minus 1, then the relationship between A and B is directly proportional with each other, right? Okay, and if they tend to be closer to 0, it means there is very very less relationship, right? So this is the significance of correlation coefficients and covariance. That's all. Thank you, students.